हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ स्नेहल शिंदे, लेक्चरर इन प्रवीण पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ डिप्लोमा इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रिकल डिपार्टमेंट. सब्जेक्ट इज एलिमेंट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स. सब्जेक्ट कोड इज 2213, यूनिट 1, सेमीकंडक्टर डायोड. नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी विल स्टडी P-N junction diode. Our first diode is the P-N junction diode. So the P-N junction is the basic building block on which the operation of all the semiconductor device is dependent. The behavior of the P-N junction is developed based on the semiconductor properties. Diode means a device with two elements, namely anode and cathode. Since a PN junction itself is a two element device, it becomes the most basic electronic device, that is the diode. So the p-type semiconductor and n-type semiconductor are joined together with the help of a special fabrication technique to form a p-n junction diode. Then the terminals are brought out from the external connection with the p and n-type semiconductor. The p side is called as the anode and the n side is called as a cathode. The n side consists of large number of electrons and few thermally generated holes, whereas the p side consists of large number of holes and a few thermally generated electrons. Therefore, the electrons are majority carriers and the holes are the minority carriers in the N region, whereas their roles are exactly opposite in the P region. The PN junction forms the basic semiconductor device called as a diode. The understanding of characteristics and behavior of a PN junction proves to be useful to understand the operation of many semiconductor devices. At the junction, one side has a concentration of holes, whereas the other side has a high concentration of the electrons. Due to this concentration, gradient is created across the junction and the process of diffusion of the charge carrier. So the p-type material and n-type material join is called as a junction. You can see the depletion region. So when no external voltage is applied between the terminals of the p-n junction, hence the p-n junction is said to be unbiased. The free electrons from N side will diffuse into the P side and recombine with the holes present there. Each electron diffusing into the P side will leave behind a positive immobile ion on the N side. When an electron combines with a hole on the P side, an atom which accepts this electrons loses its electrically neutral status and becomes a negative immobile ion. So the depletion region on both the sides of the junction, it contains only immobile ions and no free charge carriers such as electrons or holes. In other words, this region is depleted on the free charge carriers. Therefore, this region is called as a depletion region. So practically, the width of depletion region is 0.5 to 1 micrometer. It is very small as compared to the PN regions. This region is also known as the space charge region. In the state of equilibrium, the depletion region gets widened to such an extent that electrons cannot cross the junction anymore. In state of equilibrium, the depletion region gets widened to such an extent that electrons cannot cross the junction anymore. So this is the PN junction diode, and the below that it is a PN junction symbol. Anode and cathode are the two terminals of the PN junction diode. So how can you recognize the component PN junction diode? So this is the below figure indicates the component indication. So here is the black color line towards the cathode terminal. So you can easily identify the cathode terminal. The black ring near the terminal is the terminal called as a cathode terminal. And next is the anode terminal. So this is the indication for the cathode terminal. So this is the component representation of the PN junction diode. Now next we will study the forward biasing of a PN junction diode. It is nothing but the working of the PN junction diode. In the figure you can see there is a PN junction diode, means P-type material, it is connected to the N-type material, okay? Then, what mean by forward biasing? If P-type semiconductor is connected to the positive terminal of the battery or the DC source, and N-type of semiconductor, it is connected to the negative terminal of the battery or source, it is called as a forward biasing of the PN junction diode. So if the P region anode is connected to the positive terminal of the external DC source and N side cathode is connected to the negative terminal of the DC source, then the biasing is said to be forward biasing. Current limiting resistor is used for the avoid the excess amount of the current to flow through the junction of the diode. Due to the negative terminal of the external source connected to the N region, free electrons from N side are pushed towards the P side. Similarly, the positive end of the supply will push holes from P side towards the N side. With increase in the external supply voltage V, more and more number of holes P side and electrons N side start traveling towards the junction as shown in the figure. The holes will start converting the negative ions into the neutral atoms, and the electrons will convert the positive ions into the neutral atom. As a result of this, the width of depletion region will reduce. Due to the reduction in the depletion region width, the barrier potential will also reduce. Eventually, at a particular value of voltage, the depletion region will collapse. Now, there is absolutely no opposition to the flow of the electrons and holes. Hence, a large number of electrons and holes that are the majority carriers can cross the junction under the influence of the external connected DC voltage as shown in the figure. So, what is the barrier voltage? Due to the presence of immobile positive and negative ions on opposite sides of the junction, an electric field is created across the junction. This electric field is known as the barrier potential or junction potential or cutting voltage. The polarities of the barrier potential are decided by the type of immobile ions present on two sides of the junction. Therefore, the negative terminal of the barrier potential is on the P side and positive side is on the N side. This is called as a barrier potential because it acts as a barrier to oppose the flow of the electrons and holes across the junction. The barrier potential represents the height of the barrier that is to overcome for commencement of the flow of electrons and holes. Barrier potential is measured in volts. The barrier potential for silicon is about to 0.6 volts, whereas the value for germanium is 0.2 volts at 25 degree Celsius. So now we have studied the PN junction diode, its symbol, then how it is formed, how it is recognized. So the symbol, it is having the two terminals, anode and cathode. The arrowhead in the symbol points in the direction of the conventional current through the device. The conventional current through a diode flows from anode to cathode. This current will flow through the diode if and only if an external voltage source is connected to it with the appropriate polarities. Then biasing of the PN junction diode. When the PN junction is formed, the depletion region gets created and the movement of electrons and holes stop. Therefore, the current flowing through the unbiased PN junction is zero. So, we have studied in this lecture the forward biasing of the diode, PN junction diode, where the current flows. So, this was the introduction of the PN junction diode in the forward bias, where P-type terminal is connected to the positive side and N-type terminal is connected to the negative side. In next lecture, we will study PN junction diode in the reverse bias. Thank you.